Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I recently replaced the speakers of my Santa Cruz. I didn't get an aftermarket amp because I don't listen to loud music that often, so I don't want to go through the hassle of running the wire from the battery to the amp. So I only replaced the speakers because I only want a better sound quality for the truck. So today I'll show you guys how to do it. It's pretty straightforward.
Okay, so to upgrade the speakers for the Santa Cruz, you would need a few things. You need the component speakers for the front, coaxial speaker for the rear. I'm using JBL here, but any brand would work as long as they are 6.5 inch. Some green terminals for the wiring, speaker wires, blind tools, double side tap to mount the crossover if you use a component speaker with separate crossover. This one right here is the major audio connectors. I highly recommend you guys to get them. You don't need to. You can just strip off the wires and connect them directly. But if you want to keep the wiring clean and all of the original connectors of the car stay intact, then yeah, get this. That will make the job much easier. Then if you use the JBL speaker like I do, you also need some metric M3 size screw. That is for mounting the speakers. Then you need the speaker adapter. So this is a 3D print I designed. It's free. I'll post the file in the descriptions. So you can just print it. If you don't have a 3D printer, then you will need to buy some universal mount adapter. I'll post some in the description as well. And last but not least, the soundproofing mat. All right, that's all we need.
Okay, so before you open the door panel, there are two screws you have to open.
The first one is here underneath the mat, so you can use a screwdriver to try to pry it off, but that may scratch the thing inside. There's an easier way to do it by using just a piece of tape like this. Try and then try to put a screw on that and just lift it up. There you go. You see, easy piece of cake. And there you go, the screws right there. You can just use any screwdriver to open it.
Okay, and then the second screw that you need to remove is here on the side of the door. And for this one right here, I would use whichever smallest antennas you have possible to pry this cap open. And after you open it, you will see the screw and you'll be able to open it. After removing the screws, you can start flying the door open. First you have to ply the cover for the tweeter out, because this door right here, later on you need to lift it up to open it. So this will block it. So I will start from here around this corner. This is where the first pin is, and then after that this corner. This is where the second pin is. After you pry both of them out, you will be able to remove it. Then for the door, I will start at the bottom. This corner I found that it's easier to start around here. This corner right here. To pry all the way up until around here and stop. Don't try to pry up here, because over here you have a vertical latch over here. So if you try to pry it on top, you may break it. So that vertical latch make you have to push the door up to open it. I'll show you later. And then the same story on this side right here. I will start around here and pry it open up. For the rear panel, it's a very similar. You would also have to remove the mat here, which I already did, and then unscrew that screw there. And you also have to start from the top by removing that piece and then start plying down from the bottom up, starting from the corner as well. So when plying stuff out,
I found that sometimes it's easier to use two ply tools and try to insert them about 1 inch apart like this, and then try to ply both of them around the same time. That would make things come off easier.
After you remove the panel for both the front and rear doors, there will be two cables that you need to remove. The first one is here. It is for the door opener. So you just press the latch like that and put it out. Then there's the speaker connector right here. And this one, there's a latch on the side. Just have to find it and have like try to pull it out.
So after I opened the side panels, I saw some problem, and I don't know if it happens to your car as well, and whether this is a manufacturer defect. But you see, like, it happens on both of the rear doors, that there are wires trapped inside the panels, and you see the wires right here. My car has not parked under the rain or has been washed for a couple of days. The last time we got water on it was like 3 days ago when I was driving in the rain, and since then had never done anything else. But you see, there's water there. I don't know if this is a concern or not, but yeah, let me know what you think in the comments.
Okay, so this is the rear panel that I removed, and after that you see that there will be four screws you need to open there, here, here, and here. I already removed three of them, and then there's a the speaker cable over here that you need to remove. You see that there's a little latch over there. Just press it, just press and then pull. There you go, that's it. And after that, just remove the screws and pull the speaker out.
After taking the stock speaker out, you can start putting the new speaker together. You would need an adapter ring in order to mount the new speaker to the panel. And as I said earlier, I designed 3D print for this. You can use it as in this photo.
Another thing is, if you use my 3D print for the speaker adapter, depends on the side of the car. In this case, in this example, I'm using the right side. You want to keep the wires to the right of the corner that has a cut off like this. The reason is because when you put it into, when you install the speaker, you see it has a thing that stick out like this. This is where the cutoff side of the adapter goes to, and then there's a gap to the right of it. So this is where you're gonna pull the wire to, and that's why if you align the adapter and the wire like this, it will make it easier, more convenient to install later. So when you open the driver panel, there will be three cables you need to remove instead. So this one and this one are the same in every door. On the driver side, you also have this one. So make sure you remove all three of them before pull the panel out. And by the way, for this one, there's a little latch over here. You have to press it and pull it. Sometimes it can be stuck. Kept hard, so you can try to press it and try move it, like, you know, like side to side, and it may come up easier. And by the way, this is where the vertical latch that I mentioned earlier here, and this is why you don't want to try to ply on the top, because it may break this. So by the time you ply off all of these pins right here, then you just like hold the panel and just lift it up. And so this will come up easily. Okay, so one thing I tried to look up on the internet and I couldn't find out is that where the heck is the crossover for this car, for the front door, because I look over here, I didn't see anything, nothing at all.
And there's no documentations or spec talking about it. And I could open the wire to trace back to see what's going on, but I don't want to do that. Again, I want to keep almost everything like stay the same as the original wiring and parts, things like that. So I don't want to open it up. But here, what I think what happened here is that they run the woofer and the tweeter in parallel. So this is the tweeter that I removed earlier, and you see, I think this is what they use to filter out the lower frequency for the tweeter. They use a little capacitor there, and so that's why it doesn't have its own crossover for this system, the stock system. And so what I decide to do is I'll just skip the original wire to the tweeters. I'll run the wire from my crossover to the aftermarket tweeter later. And so I'll take the wire here from the woofer and fit into the crossover as an input, and I just take whatever the woofer out and the tweeter out and connect to my aftermarket woofer and tweeter later on over there. So, and I hope I'm right. So let's see. Okay, so after opening the panels, you can start wiring the speakers. Here I'm showing the wiring for the driver front door. The rear will be much simpler because it doesn't involve the component speakers, which I can show later. But here, let's look at this. So I'm using the JBL, which come with this crossover, but I assume all of the other component speaker would have the same interface, which you have an input here. This is the your music signals that go into the crossover, and it will split out into woofer and tweeter. So at the beginning, we talk about preparing some metra cable. So you see, if you have the metra cable, this right here, you just need to make some green terminal and connect it to the metra connector. And then this metra connector right here can be plugged in directly to the stock cable right here, right? The original cable from Hyundai. Then after that, it's just a matter of wiring, you know, the woofer to the woofer, and the tweeter to the tweeter. So I'll show later after I'm complete. For mounting the crossover, I found that the arrow right here just behind the motors, so you have the motor right here for the door. This right here is the perfect area. It's flat enough that you can use the double-sided tape to tape the crossover and just attach it like this, and it will stay nicely there. So this is what I'm gonna do, maybe around here like that. All right, here we go after all the wiring's done. So you see, this is where I mount the crossover with the double-sided tape, and it's pretty solid, very it stuck very well over there. And there you go. So this one right here is the input signal to the speakers. And this the original was the input to the woofer. So now it come to the input, and then the woofer out goes to the my JBL speakers woofer, and then this tweeter right here go all the way over there, and that's it. And so we are done with the front doors. The passenger side is similar, actually it's the same technically. So you just need to mount the crossover accordingly and wiring the same way. All right. Okay, after
you install the speaker, and you see the wire coming from there, bottom, the hole that we was seeing earlier. So you go out there, and then you just need to connect it to the speaker cable, like that. So, and this is why buying the major connectors really help you, save you a lot of hassle later. Just make it super easy to connect. All right, so this is what it looks like after a complete speaker replacement for the driver's side. So on the rear, you only need the speaker right there, and mount it and connect through the major connector there. And again, there's a gap below it. That's where you should keep the wire at. When it gets to mounting the tweeter, it's a little bit tricky, because you look at the stock tweeters, you see that it comes with a mount that's already kept like fixed to the tweeter itself, so we cannot reuse it. And this one right here, it's not quite a flexible housing that we can mount any kind of tweeter in there. So you're gonna have to customize somehow to mount a tweeter. If you use the JBL speakers like I do, then it actually come with some kind of housing for the tweeter itself that you can put a screw over. And so I use that, and then I design this bracket right here, 3D printed. And so that will allow me to mount everything nicely together onto this one. It's very solid, you know, like see, it stuck very well. And then it still has a little gap over there, you see, so that it doesn't touch the grill over here at all. It looks nicely aligned very well with the stock panel. So so that's what I did to mount the tweeter to the original panel. And then these are just the original tweeter cable, just plugged into the wiring that I was showing earlier. So after you mount the tweeter to the panel, I would suggest put some kind of like soundproofing over there, just to, you know, avoiding scratching to the panel or anything like that. It will look like this. Everything will look like this. So that is the wires that we run from the crossover earlier. And then this one is it. That's it. We just need to plug it in and we are done. Alright, so I finally got all of the speakers replaced. And as mentioned earlier, I didn't have an aftermarket amp. I only got the speakers replaced, and so far the sound quality was much better. I can hear the instrument much clearer, bass is warmer, more accurate, everything's better. And so if you're looking to upgrade the speakers, maybe try without an amp first, and if that's not enough, you can always add an amp later. Because it's much simpler to replace the speakers themselves. You don't have to run the wire from the battery for the amp and so on. So, all right. So I hope that this helps you guys to replace the speaker easier if you want to. All right. Bye.